What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today, the Winnipeg Jets take on the St. Louis Blues, trying to snap their three-game losing streak where they have looked horrid. Just two goals in their last three games. This has not been a good stretch for the Jets. Can they fix it? A game before the All-Star break, can they go into the All-Star break happy and on a good note? Well, let's take a look at the lines. Oy vey, those are indeed lines. Rick Bonus trying to make a statement here, I guess. Nick Ehlers on the fourth line, Dubois on the third line, Lowry up in the top six, and Carson Kuhlman for some reason on the top line. I wonder if the Jets will be able to score this game. Well, despite getting a lot of shots on goal, Jordan Binnington did play pretty good in the first period and he stopped the Jets, but the Jets just could not capitalize on their opportunities tonight. In the first half of the game at least, because just fanning on shots, passing too much, maybe trying to be too cute, just wasn't working for them at the beginning of the game, and it was 0-0 after one. So those lines stayed together. I thought maybe those were just out for a period there, just to let the Stars know that they did a bad thing the last couple of games. They haven't been playing up to standards, so I thought that was just the message, but no, the line stayed the same in the second, and shocker, the Jets don't get anything. Despite having north of 25 shots on goal at the end of the second period, the Jets head into the third down 1-0 as Jake Neighbors, with just over 5 minutes left in the second, would score on the power play, his fourth of the year. Winnipegger Jake Neighbors, by the way, sinking the Jets here into a 1-0 hole. And it's just the same old story. The Jets, coming out, just can't get it going, can't finish, can't score. Really been the story as of late, and the Blues maybe get up to an undeserving 1-0. Also, I don't know why Rick Bonus didn't challenge this goal. This was pretty offside, I thought anyway. I only saw a couple of replays, but from what I saw, I thought it was offside. Maybe I'm totally wrong on that. Maybe he was able to keep the skate above the blue line there. But to me, I thought it was offside. Fans were pissed off in the arena. They were booing him for not challenging it. And I thought it was a weird one. But anyway, the Jets, getting their chances, but just not able to capitalize. 0-6 on the power play through two periods. And we head into the third, and I see Ehlers, Shifley, Connor. I'm thinking, oh, well, Bones has put together the lineup again. He's stopped these weird lines. And then just as I get some hope, here comes Alexandrov? I don't know who that is, but he scored his third of the year for St. Louis. And the Jets are down 2-0. I thought it was over. But just when everybody lost hope, there is Josh Norrissey, future captain of your Winnipeg Jets, scoring just 40 seconds after the Alexandrov goal to make it 2-1, and he's firing up the crowd. He's telling them to get hyped. He's telling them to quit booing. We are back. Let's rally. Let's get behind us. Let's get going. And 7 minutes later, Mark Scheifele did just that, scoring his 30th of the year and tying up this game on a beautiful goal from Connor and Ehlers. And just like that, the Jets are right back in this game. And then guess who? Just over 20 seconds later, Josh Morrissey goes, throws it at the net off a Blues skate, and in Josh Norrissey, taking the team and putting it on his back. And just like that, guys, the Jets are up 3-2 when all looked lost. This game would keep on going right to the end, and it would be Blake Wheeler giving it to Mark Scheifele for the empty netter. Jets are going to walk away with this one with a 4-2 win. Jordan Binnington collapse. You love to see it. We didn't get to see him, throw stuff around today, which is kind of unfortunate. Looks like he was told to behave today. And hey, Jets win. I'm very happy they broke this losing streak that's been plaguing them for the last week. This was one of the uglier losing streaks in recent memory that I remember anyway. This might rival the 9-game losing streak that the Jets had a couple years ago, but that was a pretty rough 3 games. Hopefully this means they've turned the corner heading into the All-Star break now. This game was a little frustrating because it felt like Rick Bonus was just trying to, prove his point. And I think he proved it after the first period. And I think from there, he could have just gone back to the regular lines or made a configuration of them, at least to have your stars playing. Prove that you've learned something, right? Because the whole point of the lines being weird today was to demote the Stars, make them feel kind of and get them going again, get them working to earn their spots back. I think that he could have probably put the lines together. Maybe we would have had more success, but I don't know. That's just me talking here. But overall, the Jets played pretty good, and then they played really good in the last 15 minutes of the game to seal this one. Big ol' shining star of the game award. I don't even think I have to tell you guys who get it. So you already know who's getting the award today. It's Josh Norrissey putting the team on his back. Dustin Byfuglien-esque game from Josh Morrissey. Very excited for this guy. He had a kind of a rough few games, went pointless, and we haven't seen Morrissey go pointless in a long time, for a long stretch of time. But hey, two goals today. Sure, he's not going to complain. He's got 10 on the year now. Josh just continues to have an incredible year. But, you know, something going on outside of the Jets organization today. Atu Ratti, a first-round pick, and Anthony Beauvillier traded from the New York Islanders to the Vancouver Canucks for Bo Horvat. That is a big trade. And I'm, you know, I kind of expected Horvat to go for a little bit more, but I guess, you know, the Islanders do make a pretty good trade there. Beauvillier, I feel like he's been in the league forever, but he's actually only 25. Maybe he can find that magic again that he had a couple years ago with the Islanders when they went on that big cup run there, falling short, of course, but he played really good in the playoffs a couple of seasons ago. I believe that was the bubble year. And then Atu Ratti, really solid center prospect. I really like him. And a first-round pick, obviously, is super valuable, especially this year with all the talent in the draft. But Bo Horvat is off the board now, so if any Jets fans were hoping that Bo would come to Winnipeg, that does not seem to be the case. I didn't think that Horvat was going to be a Jet. It just really didn't see the fit there, but, you know, of course, people like to talk about it, and it was fun, but I think the Jets should be setting their sights elsewhere, maybe for a top six winger, and maybe a defenseman in there too, if they can figure that out. But yeah, just, you know, my thoughts on the trade. I think that Vancouver actually could have probably gotten more, but overall, I think it's a good haul for both sides. But yeah, guys, I am going to hop on out of here. Thank you so much for watching the video. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought about the game, what you thought about Josh Morrissey putting the team on his back. Would love to hear from you guys. Leave a like and subscribe to the video if you haven't already. We are so close to 1K. I believe we're only like 70 subs off or something like that at the time I'm making this. So yeah, definitely subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in the next one. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.